Hello, Jeanette. I've sent several messages in the past week that passed, but you haven't replied. You didn't attend his funeral, too. This would be my final message regarding him. His lawyer has summoned us for his will reading tomorrow. I just got off the call with him myself. I thought it might interest you to know. Best regards.
Big sis! Now you're finally speaking in a language that I understand. Your previous messages were all about contributing towards funeral expenses. And I had faith in your financial capacity, coupled with Dad's wealth, to settle all of those. You really cannot blame me for not responding. I didn't know what to say.
Yeah, right. I believe you know your way around getting to Dad's old manor in Brecker State. His lawyer seems keen on punctuality. Do not be late.
I wonder why the lawyer chose you to share all these things. Doesn't he have my number?
He chose to talk to the responsible one. His words, not mine.
Oh, I see. You're suddenly the responsible one now. Where were you when your beloved father was ill? Where was your responsibility when your father had to go in for surgery and he needed a blood donor? Where was your responsibility then?
I'm amazed. Partly because you know these things, but majorly because you're accusing me as though you are not also guilty of the very same things.
I'm trying to let you see that we're cut from the same cloth. There's no such thing as the responsible one between us.
It's not a competition, Jane. Just be present tomorrow.
Yeah, sis. See you tomorrow. I can wait to see what I got from Daddy Dearest. What the actual fudge, sis? What on earth was that lawyer on about?
What a fine way to go about saluting Jane. That lawyer you speak of has a name. I believe he introduced himself as Greg before he began the proceedings. What I want to know is the rationale behind storming off in the middle of the meeting.
That's barely the big issue, sis. You told me Dad's will reading is today, and that's why I was in attendance in the first place. You surely would not expect my time to be thoroughly wasted, listening to an autobiography of one of my least favorite people in the world? What on earth is the meaning of that? Don't you ever trick me like that again!
You shouldn't be furious with me. It was the exact information I got from the lawyer that I shared with you. And I believe he said that to get us there, because it was important to listen to what Dad really wanted to tell us, but couldn't in his lifetime.
Yeah, whatever. I don't give a damn about what life lessons he wanted to pass around and whatnot. What I'm interested in is how much I get from his ill-gotten wealth. You can sit through the entire nonsense and let me know when it gets to the part of the will.
These are very cruel things to say, Jane, especially to your own father.
Stop acting all self-righteous. We both know the reason you suddenly care is because of the inheritance, too. So drop the act.
I don't care about the inheritance. You can have it all for all I care. I just want to find closure in the last moments of Dad. If I knew that he was going through everything we heard, that he would die so suddenly, I wouldn't have held on so tightly to my grudge.
I don't know why you're telling all of this, but I want to let you know that it doesn't matter to me.
I'm telling you because I want you to understand that even though we suffered, Dad suffered too. And all we can do for him, now that he's gone, is forgive him.
I rolled my eyes so hard after reading this that it's a wonder they didn't fall off. You can keep on pretending to fool others, but you don't fool me. And really? I'm not interested in all these things you're saying. Just let me know what I get from it all. Bye. Out of all people that would do this to me, it just had to be the one person that betrayed herself to be a saint. Gosh. I'm amazed at how well you act.
What is going on?
And don't even dare to try patronizing me! So much for I don't want any of it now, eh?
You have to tell me what is going on, Jane. I do not know what you're on about.
You're a liar, a thief, and a cheat. That's what's going on. You deserve to be beaten to a pulp and burnt alive.
Okay, you have got to pull a plug there. If you're not interested in talking about what's wrong, then I guess I'll just have to leave you on here and head right back to bed. Because I'll not sit by my phone in the small hours of the day only to be reading death threats from you.
So now, you're acting all fancy as much as you've been playing the Clueless charades! Keep at it. I don't give a damn. Just know that all your ill-gotten inheritance won't last you. I'm going to make sure of it.
Oh, I see. I now get it. You finally swallowed all your pride to have a chat with Greg, right? And you now think I may have altered the contents of Dad's will, correct?
Yes. Laugh as much as you want. Take a swing at it, in fact. Because I'm promising you that you won't laugh for long. I'm going to sue. And it is said that the one who laughs last, laughs best.
Keep your threats as well as your words of wisdom to yourself, Jane. I'm not moved by anything you're saying here.
I'm not asking you to be moved. I'm just telling you my move, so you can be forearmed.
We'll see then. I've wasted time having this useless conversation. Good night.
I wonder how you sleep at night, knowing that you're nothing but an evil sister. Villains should be taking notes from. You might think your secret is safe, but I'm going to make sure everyone gets to know what you did. How you cheated me of my birthright.
And what did I do? How have I cheated you exactly? I would like to know if Greg told you something, or you're just assuming on your own.
Oh, now you're suddenly interested in what I know? Prepare for the worst, girl. Your downward spiral is about to start.
Well, I'm not bothered at all by your empty threats. I'd advise that you think properly before taking any action. I didn't do anything but unknowingly fulfill the prerequisite for inheriting his wealth. Dad left everything in the name for the family member who would sit through the reading of his autobiography. I happened to be the only person that cared enough to do so, and I remembered calling you every single time I went for the hearing. You can scroll down on the chats to see all the texts I sent for you to make it, if you could. All of which were ignored. I didn't even know this was going to be the end result of it all. I just wanted clarity and closure from reading the handwritten manuscript of Dad. You cannot fault me caring enough to be willed a fortune to.
That's just a pile of cow dung, Crystal. I'm not interested in your storybook lies. By the time I'm done with you, you'll wish you never crossed me.
All these threats of yours can land you behind bars. I'm not going to take them lightly anymore. I still stand on my disinterest for all of the wealth, because I don't think I deserve any of it. There are more eligible heirs than the both of us, and they're not as agitated as you are. They're not even agitated at all. I'd rather give it to those people than to think of giving it to you.
So, you're planning on redistributing? Or that's just another lie of yours to get me?
A clause in the will prevents me from redistributing for the next 24 months, but after that time frame, I'll redistribute to the people who helped take care of Dad while he was sick and give the rest to charity. With this attitude of yours, I'm going to make sure a penny from it all doesn't find its way into your grasp.
How can you be cruel to your own sister? Do you know how much I've lost depending on all of this to fall through? I left my job. I mortgaged my apartment. I'm neck deep in debt. You've got to help me get something out of all of this. And as soon as possible, too.
All of your problems are none of my concern, Jane. I watched you make posts of your shopping sprees and vacations while I struggled with expenses for Father's funeral. His body had to be shipped in from this retirement home in Saudi Arabia. I sent word to you, but you did nothing to help out. His funeral program spent 3 days and you were nowhere to be seen. You showed up for his will reading and stormed out when you realized what it really was. All you have shown Father's lawyer, as well as the rest of his business partners, associates, and extended family, is how much you're bitter. Materialistic women who is very capable of squandering inheritance gotten on a platter. Therefore, undeserving of Father's wealth. Even if it was left to them, you still won't be getting a penny.
Well, I don't give a fudge about them. They were not there when Daddy abandoned me for work. They were not there when that dead man wasn't there when I needed him the most. They were not there when Daddy would miss all my parent-teacher's meet and career day in school. My anger is justified. I suffered a lot for him to garner all the wealth he left behind. None of them are entitled to tell me otherwise.
I went through the exact same thing, Jane. I went through worse. Because I was molested by the staff dad hired to watch over us, and he knew. But he was too busy to interview a replacement. So that went on for years. You think you're the only one who got the short end of the stick? You think that every hour I stayed back in Father's house weren't the hardest of my life? I was protecting you, because I didn't want the same thing to happen with you. I bore most of the brunt of Dad's workaholism. You were too young to have known how I was brutalized by the woman he remarried after Mother died. For the sole purpose of taking care of us. It's a lot of horrible things to say. If I keep dwelling, a lot of horrible things I passed through. There was someone who had a better excuse for not having anything to do with Dad, even after his death, then that would be me. But I'm grown enough to understand that we punished him enough in his lifetime and went too far even. That doesn't make me deserving of all of his wealth even still. That's why I'll redistribute. But I reiterate that I'll make sure you get nothing because you're the least deserving of anything that man has. You can try throwing all you have at me, but that doesn't change anything.
So now you want to play God? You will make sure I won't get anything? Well, F you! I don't care!
Good. We've come to an understanding then. You've already kept me awake long enough. I don't plan on spending another second. Have a nice life. Jeanette, what is the meaning of the things I've been reading all over the place? Are you being serious right now? You granted an interview to a channel, only to get there and peddle all sorts of lies regarding me. You called me unprintable names on the live television, and posted photoshopped receipts of our conversation online. All your lies are viral, all over social media and beyond, and do you know what all the buzz this is causing me for my small businesses?
You were typing a lot of words just last night, about how I am unable to do anything to challenge you. So, why are you so furious now? You thought because of your inherited billions, you've attained a level of immunity? You think you're now untouchable? I think you're now seeing the consequences that come with crossing me, sister dearest. Your businesses are yet to suffer. I'm going to keep singing about your cruelty until there's nothing left of that facade that you call a reputation you wear in front of people. Then, you'll understand that money is not the answer to everything.
It is seeming like you do not understand the consequences of what you're doing, not only to me, but also to yourself. I'm going to plead, for the sake of our blood ties, that you take down whatever lies you've put out there against me. I'm advising you to do a public apology as damage control. You can tell me the number of days you need to make that happen, but it will have to be soon, and you have to quench the storms of angry mobs you've raised against me.
There's nothing bad in all you've said. Nothing at all. You just have to keep your imaginations to yourself. Because there's no way in your wildest dreams that I'm going to be doing anything in relation to the above. Even if you fall to my feet and grovel.
I'm not the enemy, Jane. And I'm really not interested in being your enemy. You should know that by now.
It's hilarious to see you so humble in my DMs! Were you not the one bragging about how I'll never amount to anything with my entitlement? Now you can actually type that I'm not your enemy? The battle line has been drawn since the moment I heard the stunt that you pulled from Dad's lawyer. Buckle in, sweetie. Cause the ride of your life has only just begun.
In that case, you've left me no other choice. Stay tuned for what comes next. At least you wouldn't say, I didn't try to make peace or warn you for that matter. Bye for now. Jeanette had thought it was a joke when she received a court's notice about her being charged for libel, defamation of character, and cyberbullying. She'd even come to my DMs to gloat about how my best was a court's notice. However, after her failure to attend the first hearing, and she was arrested, she finally understood the enormity of the problem she'd walked right into. It wasn't a walk in the park to clear my name, especially in the social media space where Jeanette has conjured up an army of minions as angry and bitter as she was. But one post after another credible evidence is, my team, which consisted of my lawyer, a PR expert, and a social media manager, were able to slowly win us brownie points from the public. The hearings, especially after Jeanette's arrest, became a public affair. We went as far as engage in media houses to televise the hearings for the viewership of all who cared to see the truth. My sister and her minions were cunning enough to open up a fundraiser at the beginning of the entire thing, so they were able to afford a good lawyer that seemed to have taken a degree in college of lies and manipulation too. It was a tough 18 weeks of hearings and adjournments, even further hearings before we finally got the jury to make a verdict. The jury ruled in our favor and fined my sister a whopping $1 million for cyberbullying and defamation, or face a 1.5 year jail term. By then, we'd already swept the social media space off their feet, with the truth and her army had dwindled to next to nothing. My heart broke to see her distraught expression after the verdict was given. She'd begged me severally before the verdict that we should settle out of court, but I knew Jeanette would never learn if it wasn't the hard way. Her plan to make money off public sympathy had clearly backfired, and with the backlash she was facing, it would be harder for her now, more than ever, to raise $1 million. So she was really going to jail, with the hopes that she was going to get some form of reformation after serving her time. I moved on to focusing on all my businesses, with the new additions of the inherited ones. My dad's associates were at first skeptical about me, especially after Jeanette came out to say what she did. But after they saw how I'd handled it, they were convinced that I was really the right person that would have inherited the fortune. I didn't really believe that, nor did I care for the increasing fame the entire experience had gotten me. But it was good. Really good for business, so I couldn't complain.